Hello, my name is Kaymond, and in today's video, I'll show you how to build a super efficient Enderman XP farm. Now, let me show you how this farm actually works. So up there, we have an Endermite, and when the Enderman spawn in here, you will see the Endermite go crazy, run in here. The thing they can walk across here, but they can't, so try to jump up and fall down. As you can see, oh, there's so many Endermans here already. And as you can see, it works quite nicely. Not a single Enderman can get stuck. And that's one of the reasons why this farm is so efficient. And here are some of the items you need for the build. Loads of building blocks and loads of slabs. 6 chests, 9 hoppers, 8 trapdoors, you can use any trapdoor you want to, 16 glass blocks, 8 rails, 1 minecart, 1 name tag, and an anvil so you can rename your name tag. 10 2 buckets of fodder so you can make an infinite fodder source. I will show you how to do this later. Ender pearls, because we need to spawn a endermite. And the only way to do this in survival is with ender pearls. And last but not least, a sword so we can test out the farm. This design is a follow-up to my older Enderman XP farm. In this one, I improved it quite a lot and made it a lot more efficient. So yeah, this is the Enderman XP farm version 3. Now, the first thing you will have to do is to find yourself an end portal and jump inside. And once you have done that, go in here to one of the sides or the edges of the end island and place a slab in here. Bottom half slabs. And then go 128 blocks in that direction. You can also go further than that, but 128 blocks is the minimum. And once you're here, 128 blocks away from the end island, make yourself a 15 by 15 square platform. The best way to do it is to build up the sides first, like this, and then just fill the middle up. Now take out some slabs and build the sides up in here, like so, all the way around. You do not have to add these slabs here, but I think it makes this look a lot more nicer. And you are less likely to accidentally jump down. So yeah, that's a plus, am I right? Then let's go in the middle. You got your hoppers and your chests. The middle is somewhere in here. And now, also dig out these 2 blocks or 6 blocks from here and add the chests in here. Like so. And then let's go back here and crouch right at the chest with a hopper in your hand, like that, so they will connect. Same thing to all of these chests. And we can test this out by throwing some items inside. One in here, here, and in here. And now we should have an item inside each chest. And yeah, it's working quite nicely. And now let's place some slabs above the hoppers. Again, crown so that open the hopper. We want to place the slabs in here. And now we need to go up. Place a block in here and go 42 blocks up, counting from this block. And be aware, Endermen can now spawn on top of these blocks for now. We will fix that later, but please do not look at them in their eyes, otherwise they will attack you. But yeah, 42 blocks up, counting from this block. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. And now once you're up here, you need to get down. And the easiest way to do it is with a bucket of fodder. Just place a bucket of fodder down and yeah, go with the flow basically. And once you're down here, break this block and replace this block with a slab. Alright, from here you can kill the Endermans quite easily. Then go around with slabs, all the way around, and connect it in here. Apart from here, you will build the tower basically up. Up all the way. And once you have done that, go up here and add 2 more rows of blocks. Put the first row and the second one. And then on each corner, add a slab. But Endermans can't spawn up here. And now build the walls up all the way around like this. This will also save you loads of blocks and it will look a little bit nicer. And like that. Once again, take out a bucket of fodder and go down. Now go to one of the corners, place 2 blocks like that. leaving one gap under it here. And then a third block up here. Break the blocks below and build up yourself a roof. So the Enderman can spawn in here or teleport in here to basically surprise you and kill you. So yeah, that's why the roof is quite important. And once you have done that, go out here and make one more row of blocks all the way around. And then take out some water. And as you only have two buckets of water, place the first two in here. And refill from the middle. Do the same thing on all the sides. And then the last one in here. And then let's place some more buckets of water in here like so. So all of these blocks turn into water source blocks. Just refill your buckets from here and you should be okay. And the last thing we had to do is to break these side blocks because the Enderman can still spawn up in here. So yeah, let's do that right now. And then near the entrance, add 8 slabs in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Break this block. And yeah, sometimes the water goes all the way up here. Sometimes it does not. I don't know why it did it this time. But yeah, looks a lot more better as well. And now because we have water up here, the Enderman cannot spawn or teleport in here. I mean, they can still teleport, but they don't like water. So yeah, they won't teleport in here. But yeah, that's awesome. Now we need to go up there. So bring all the remaining items I listed at the beginning of this video, and you should be okay. Let's place a block on one of the sides and start going around. Same thing in here. Connect these up. Same thing on this side. Block here. Connect these up. Break the block for now. Okay, and same in here. Connect. And then the last part. Okay, now we'll take out some glass blocks, some trapdoors, and of course some regular good old building blocks. Now take out your glass blocks and place them in here. Break this block, and the same thing on the opposite side, break this block, and some glass. And if a Enderman spawns here, it will not drop down. And that's why we use glass, because Endermans cannot spawn on top of glass. So yeah, that's quite the big brain move. Now place some building blocks here. Break the blocks from the sides. So we have two blocks in here. Place one more above. And place some trapdoors on all of the sides. Okay. And then also up here. Just be careful so you don't drop down. Then above here, one block. And a glass block. Break the block below, and up here we will place our Endermite. Okay, so from here, on all the sides, we need to go 16 blocks out. And yeah, it's going to be a huge one. So, one, counting from this block, I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Same thing on all of the sides. And once you have done that, you will have to connect these together. So just place blocks here and blocks here until they connect. Like that. Alright. Same thing on all of the sides. And once you have done that, you have to fill these up. Oh, and by the way, if you want to save blocks, you can also use top half slabs. They will work just as fine. So yeah, use those if you don't have this many blocks. And look at that. Now we just need to fill these holes up. Like so. Let's go here in the middle. Take out your glass blocks and your building blocks once again. And go two blocks up. And all of the sides here, here as well. Of course, leave a gap here where the glass block is, or the glass walkway. Then up here, let's place some glass blocks, so Endermans can spawn up here. Slabs also work, but I think glass blocks, for some reason, look a lot more better. I don't know why. Then up here, on this glass block, we'll have to place our Endermite. of course we have to spawn it first. So make yourself a small room up here. This will be okay size. And the sides up. The sides have to be 2 blocks tall, but the endermite cannot escape. Then take out some rails. So just some regular rails. Place them in here. A minecart. Placed in here. And then, two more blocks here. And then take out your ender pearls. And make sure you are not on peaceful mode. So either easy, normal, or hard mode. And start throwing ender pearls. Oh, first try. Okay, that's crazy. Yeah, you might not be this lucky, but yeah, maybe 16 or 30 something ender pearls, and you should get a endermite. Okay, take out your name tag, name this little guy, and try to get him inside his minecart. Let's try this. Okay, the little guy is inside. Break the rails, break all the blocks, and place a glass block above the minecart. Now you can destroy the room. Okay, it seems to be working already. Yikes. Lots of endermen are spawning. Hello there. And just be careful so you don't accidentally break the glass block below the minecart. And yeah. That's the farm. Endermen spawn. Try to reach the endermite. And they will fall down. And as you can see, it's super fast. Okay. I just came here. The endermen started spawning already. Let me hit the timer for 5 minutes. And yeah, see you in 5 minutes. Okay, 5 minutes have passed. And look at this XP. So, way too much XP, this is crazy. So, I don't know, maybe 51, 52 levels in 5 minutes with this simple Enderman XP farm. Isn't that crazy? 51 levels. Excuse me, 52 XP is still coming. Oh, come on, this is crazy. Anyways, my name is Caymond. And if you found this tutorial useful, please let me know down in the comments. And yeah, please consider subscribing, hit the like button, all that stuff. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.